Ciao a tutti, welcome again. We've already stopped in a hotel and had dinner at a restaurant. What are we going this week? Facciamo la spesa! Even if you are in Italy with the entire group of people, your trip has been perfectly organized and you don't have to eat anything outside a hotel, I encourage you to do otherwise. There are many products you should try in Italy. You don't have to do shopping in a supermarket, but I think you should do small shopping in a local corner shop. You want to try prosciutto crudo, which is raw ham, and prosciutto cotto, which is boiled ham, if you prefer it. There's no better mozzarella cheese than in a small local shop in Campania. Mozzarella, you know from a supermarket, tastes completely different than this fresh one. Try it and find out if you like it. Delicious is Italian bread. I recommend pane con le olive e peperoncini. You should try different snacks, for example taralli. I like them with fennel. You might want to try different sweets, for example torrone, which I hate but many people love. But you know, I can't say I haven't tried it. It depends on your taste buds, but anyway, you should try it and find out if you like it. I know it's a drop in the ocean, but it's just to give you an idea. How can you greet someone in a shop? How can you say hello? The obvious way is buongiorno. Buongiorno. Buongiorno, which is good morning. If you arrive a bit later, you say good afternoon. Buon pomeriggio. Buon pomeriggio. Buon pomeriggio. In the evening, you say good evening. Buonasera. Buona sera. Buonasera. Can you use ciao in a shop? I would say, it depends. If the shop assistant is older than you are, I would use the safer form, this formal form. Buongiorno, buon pomeriggio, buonasera. But if he or she is young, then go ahead. Use ciao, why not? The Italians are casual and friendly and they tend to use ciao on every occasion, so I wouldn't worry so much. The shop assistant will ask you desidera, which is more or less how can I help you. When you want to buy something, you can use vorrei, which is I'd like. Vorrei. Vorrei due panini. I'd like two buns. Vorrei due panini. Vorrei due panini. Vorrei due pomodori. I'd like two tomatoes. Vorrei due pomodori. Vorrei due pomodori. If you don't want to use this form, you can simply add please at the end of the sentence, which is per favore. Due panini per favore. Due panini per favore. Two buns, please. Due panini per favore. Due pomodori per favore. Due pomodori per favore. Two tomatoes, please. Due pomodori per favore. If you want, you can use both forms. Vorrei due panini per favore. Vorrei due pomodori per favore. As you can see, it's quite simple. If you want to ask how much something is, you say quanto costa, how much is, quanto costa, quanto costa, quanto costa mozzarella fresca, quanto costa mozzarella fresca. How much is fresh mozzarella cheese? Quanto costa mozzarella fresca? Quanto costa prosciutto? Quanto costa prosciutto? How much is prosciutto? Quanto costa prosciutto? If there's no price tag on the product you want to buy, don't buy it or make sure what the price is. In Italy, they use metric system. But what's quite surprising, they don't use grams, when they buy products in a shop. They use ettogrammo, which is hectogram, so about 100 grams. If you want, for example, 100 grams of a product, you say un etto. If you want 200 grams, you say due etti. If you want 300 grams, you say tre etti. If you want 400 grams, you say quattro etti, and so on, and so on, and so on. And some additional vocabulary you might use or might want to understand. Qualcos'altro? Qualcos'altro. Qualcos'altro? Anything else? È fresco? Is it fresh? È fresco? È fresco? Che cosa raccomanda? What do you recommend? Che cosa raccomanda? Che cosa raccomanda? Una busta. Una busta. Una busta, which is a bag. Un sacchetto. Un sacchetto. Un sacchetto, which is also a bag. When you've done your shopping and ask how much you want to pay, you say quanto le devo? How much do I owe you? Quanto le devo? Quanto le devo? If you want to pay in cash, you say pago in contanti. Pago in contanti. Pago in contanti. I pay in cash. When you want to pay by card, you say pago con la carta. Pago con la carta. Pago con la carta. I pay by card. The Italians go on holiday in August. Unless you like crowded beaches and closed shops, plan your holidays, for example, in June or September. When you are in Italy, don't buy in a supermarket. Buy in a small local shop. You'll get to talk with the shop assistant. The food will be a bit more expensive, but way better. Taste different things and buy small amounts of various products. This way, you'll know the Italian cuisine much better. There are many ways to learn the vocabulary. If you go shopping, do the list in Italian, not in your mother language. This way, you'll learn new words faster. You don't have to bend over backwards to do the entire list in Italian. Do as much as you can. If you are afraid of speaking and petrified if you have to talk with the foreigner, practice. I know it can be really difficult and horrifying, especially if you are shy, but what's my advice? Step by step. Yes, do it gradually. So when you go to Italy for a week, on your first day, try to greet somebody in Italian. On your second day, try to go to a supermarket where you don't have to talk with anybody. On your third day, go to a small local shop and buy one product. On your fourth day, go to a small shop and make small talk with the shop assistant. So, step by step. And don't discourage yourself if something goes wrong. That's it. I look forward to meeting you soon. Don't forget to subscribe and thumbs up. Cheers, guys. Ciao a tutti.